You may have already been introduced to the cash flow worksheet. Regardless, we're going to review how it works, as we'll be using it quite a bit. It wouldn't hurt to get your calculator and follow along with the keystrokes to get comfortable with the process. In the TI Business Analyst 2 intro tutorial, you've been introduced to the TBM keys and to calculator worksheets in general. A main difference to keep in mind, with the TBM keys, you do not need to press enter. Simply enter a value and press the key it goes in. With worksheets, data must be specifically entered into each worksheet cell. To start with the cash flow worksheet, we'll press CF. Remember, data previously entered is retained unless cleared or overlaid. With the TBM keys, you have a finite number of keys, 5. You enter 4 and solve for the 5th, so clearing is not as critical. With the cash flow worksheet, you have a variable number of cells, so you need to clear the worksheet as you begin. To do this, press 2nd and clear work. We're going to calculate the present value and future value of the set of uneven cash flows shown on the left. So with the CF worksheet cleared, you're presented with CF0. Remember, enter a negative number, 400, plus or minus, and enter. With your calculator set to 4 decimal places, the display will change from minus 400 to minus 400 with 4 decimal places. To move between the cell entries in the worksheet, use the up and down arrows. So to go to the cell to enter CF1, press the down arrow. Enter the value 80 and press enter and down. The cash flow worksheet provides the ability to designate the frequency of equal sequential cash flows. In this example, each cash flow only occurs one time, so we can accept the default frequency of 1 and just press the down arrow. We need to repeat the process for cash flows 2 through 5. You need to get comfortable with the enter and down process. If you do not press enter for each cash flow, they're not stored in the worksheet cell. So cash flow 2 is 100, enter and down, it occurs once, down again. Cash flow 3 is 150, enter, down, and down. Cash flow 4 is 200, enter, down, and down. And our last cash flow, 225, enter, down, and down. You can always check to be sure your values are entered correctly by using the up and down arrows to review, so you can go back up and make sure you entered everything correctly. When all the cash flows have been entered, press the NPV key. The screen will display I equals for you to enter the discount rate. For our project, this rate is 8%. Remember, interest rates are entered as whole numbers, so 8 and enter and down. With NPV displayed, press compute. With the calculator set to 4 decimal places, it'll display 179.0200. Now, some financial calculators can solve for the future value of an uneven cash flow stream as well. The TI Business Analyst 2 Professional does, but the student version does not. But finding that future value is easy once you have the present value, which we just calculated. We're going to use the time value of money keys. So right now, your screen displays NPV is equal to 179.0200. We want to move this value to present value. The first thing we want to do is get out of the cash flow worksheet. So we press the clear. Now we want it to be negative. Press the plus or minus key to make it negative and PV to place it in present value. The other TBM values are N is 5, IY is 8, payment is 0, compute future value, 263.0391. Once you have the present value of an uneven cash flow stream, you can use it like a lump sum and future value it. We'll review the cash flow worksheet again later when we look at using it to solve for NPV and IRR of uneven cash flow streams.